Or one of your nation, Lord, amazing God you are. Father, Lord, we pray, show yourself strong in our midst this morning. Lord, reveal yourself to us. Show us whom you are. We don't want to leave this place without that knowledge. We want more of you. Fill us with your knowledge. Fill us with your power. Fill this place with your presence. Fill our heart with your presence. Let this word increase our faith, Lord. The Bible says faith comes by hearing the word of God. By hearing this word this morning, let our faith rise, O Lord. Lord Almighty, let us believe in you more. Let us know you more. Let us trust you more. Thank you, our Heavenly Father. I pray for all our brethren online that this word, O Lord Almighty, we impart every word right now. We pray that everyone hearing my voice right now, Lord, you begin to make their heart fertile to receive this word. It is not an empty word. The word that I speak, their spirit and their life. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, breathe on this word. Let it bless your people. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Once again, I want to welcome you to our anointing service. My prayer is that no one will leave this place the same in Jesus' name. We go with the glory of God. We go with the presence of God. Everywhere we go, the glory of God will manifest in our lives. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And just before I go on, I want always like to remind us that this is our year of open heaven. Everybody say open heaven. Say this is my year of open heaven. Deuteronomy 28 puts it very clear. This is a promise he has given us in verse 12 of it. He said that Lord will open to me his good pleasure. I want us to personalize it. Amen.
Amen.
Let's read it. Let's personalize it. One to go. The Lord will open to me his good treasure. The heavens. To give the rain to my land in its season. And to bless all the work of my hand, I shall lend to many nations, but I shall not borrow.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Can we take it one more time? And I want you to mean it. There is power in the spoken words. God told the children of Israel in the book of Numbers, he said, as I heard you speak, so I will do for you. Amen. So I want us to say it as we mean it. You know, the children of Israel, some, they went to spy the land, the promised land. 12 of them. After 40 days, they came back. And 10 said, look, it is true. The place is a land that is flowing with milk and honey. And the harvest there is great. Only bed, there are giants there. And we are like grasshoppers before them. Hey, God said, okay, you are like grasshopper. You will die like grasshopper. But those who said, he said, those people, even though they are giants, they are meat for us. They are bread for us. God said, those people, they will go and consume them. Amen. So make declaration. Open your mouth and declare the word of God. And it will come to pass. Like I've been saying something. I said, dollar will be my servant. That's my understanding about this current, this money. Dollar will be my servant. I don't know of you. Say it. Dollar will be my servant. Dollar will serve me. I will serve dollar. I will worship dollar. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's declare it one more time. The Lord will open to me and my family his good treasure. The heavens. To give the rain to my land in a season, and to bless all the work of my hand, I shall lend to many nations, but I shall not borrow. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I think Christian Message or one other translation message said, that part said, you will not need to take loan. That's the way Message put it. That's awesome. You know, in our society, taking loan is normal. But that's not the principle of the kingdom. Amen. And God is going to cause a turnaround in your finance.
Amen.
He's going to cause a turnaround in your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And this is our month of amazing testimony. I'm excited because I've been experiencing a lot of things, miracles, wonders that's causing a lot of testimony. Amen.
Amen.
And it has just started. You are a candidate for testimony.
Amen.
Not just ordinary testimony.
Amen.
Amazing word.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning, by the grace of God, we are going to extol together the nature of God. And that is the amazing God. God has been impressing it upon my heart. You know, we're talking about amazing testimony. Revelation 12:11 talks about, you know, we overcoming by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. And the Spirit of God added not just ordinary testimony, amazing testimony to me. Amen. And I begin to wonder why this amazing, why the amazing, and in the course of my, you know, meditation, I came to understand that the God we are talking about, that we bring about this testimony, is an amazing God. Amen. How many of you believe that your God is an amazing God? He's going to do amazing things in your life. Amen. God is going to amaze you.
Amen.
This is your season of amazing testimony.
Amen.
And our amazing God is at work. I see it as work. This word goes to everyone online. Today, every word that proceeds from this altar is anointed. Always. Today, the Lord is giving some prophetic word. And wherever you are, I want you to receive it by faith.
Amen.
Some word may come out that I did not even put down, I did not plan, but the Spirit of God will release it.
Amen.
Just receive it by faith and it will work for you. Because we are talking about the amazing God. You know, when miracles happen, it amazes people. Why? Because nobody can fathom. You can't just, how can this thing happen? So when we are talking about amazement, we are talking about, you know, the God is a word that illustrates the difficulty of expressing in one English word. You know, when a miracle happens, you can't really express it in a single word. How? What's the meaning of this thing? How will you? You can't just say this is just great. You like to add something to it. That is the sense of amazement God wants to drive into us. Our God is the amazing God. Amen.
Amen.
You can't express it in one English word, the wide range of emotion that and the wonder, the astonishment, you know, the awe and the joyous, you know, the joyous surprises you see in your life in our Bible. You understand? It's not just there. Amazement is the word especially used to show the effect of Christ's miracles. When you look at the Bible, the miracle of Jesus Christ, all the miracles carries amazement. People will be amazed. What is this? Amen. You see, Christ's miracle teachings, characters, and the divine personality on those who saw and heard him and were made conscious of his supernatural power. God is going to manifest his supernatural power in your matter this month. In fact, this month is not just a month of amazing testimony. God is bringing you to a season of amazing testimony.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Heaven is going to amaze you.
Amen.
Because of what he's going to do. Because in Faith and Grace Church, God takes us from glory to glory. Because we wait on him to tell us what next. And say this is that. He said, I'm going to reveal myself to you as an amazing God. Amen.
Amen.
You know, it got to a point, Moses was asking. He said, I should go and tell these people. He said, what will I tell them? What would be the name of the person that sent me? He said, go and tell them the I am that sent you. At that point, there's nothing, he has never heard of that name before. I have never thought of God being an amazing God. But God is an amazing God. Amen.
Amen.
And he's going to amaze you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the book of Matthew chapter 12, you see, the people saw the miracle of our Lord Jesus Christ. He said, and all the multitude were amazed and said, could this be the son of David? People, they will amaze. Your neighbor will amaze. We'll be amazed by what God is going to do in your life.
Amen.
By the time you share your testimony, and if you come to a point, they will say, are you the only one there? I remember in those days in our local church, when the whole thing was getting too much, we had to keep quiet because is that the only family in that church? That will be your testimony.
Amen.
They say, are you the only one there? Yes. If you have not gotten to that area, you have not started. God wants to embarrass his children. He wants to flaunt them. You know, if you are faithful to God, God will be faithful to you. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 7, when they see the wonders of God, you know, when they began, and the day of the Pentecost, what happened? When they saw the miracle of the Holy Ghost coming upon the people, the Bible says, then they were all amazed and marveled, saying to one another, look, are not all these who speak Galileans? Amen.
Amen.
Everything about our God is amazing. How many of you agree with me? Everything about this, our God, is amazing. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Look at his love. His love, his word is amazing. The love of, his love is amazingly sacrificial. You know, when you look at John 3:16, it's a very popular scripture. But when you look at it, can you express yourself like that? For you so much love your husband that you gave yourself, that gave sacrifice yourself. How many of you can do that? But you can see in that the love of Christ is such a sacrificial one that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
His love is amazing. And when you look at 1 John, you know, it's not a coincidence but a confirmation. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. 1 John 3:16 verse 8 says, by this we know love. Amen.
Amen.
Say, by this we know love because he laid down his life for us. In fact, his love is so amazing that he came to redefine love for us. Before Christ came, we are having all sorts of love. We have filios. We have all sorts of real and all sorts of fleshly love. But when Christ came, he changed the whole thing. And everybody became amazed about it. You know, how can you have one son? And because you love me so much, you say, go and die. I mean, it's so amazing. That is the kind of love. We have again. Everything about God is amazing. His love is amazing. And that love, God is going to lavish it upon you and your family this month and this season in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is going to express his amazing love in your life. He's going to lavish his love that he will ask, filling the blank check. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, if he can give his only begotten son, if he can give him up, will he not with him also give you anything? Just tell your neighbor, fill the blank check. That's what God is saying. Amazing. Everything about this, our God is amazing. Let's look at his power. His power is amazingly omni. That's how I put it. It's amazingly omni. You know omni? When we call it omnipotent. Omni is a Latin word meaning all, meaning every, meaning everything. Anything about power, it is all about God. His power is amazingly omni. Amen. All power belongs to God. The Bible says in Psalm 62, verse 11. I want you to open your Bible as we go along so that let's read our Bible. Sometimes we will not put scriptures on screen so that we will not forget where our Bibles are. Amen. God has spoken once. Psalm 62 verse 11. Open it in your Bible. And try and always bring this Bible to, you know, this paper Bible. This old rugged Bible. You know, everything is digital now. You know, God taught me a lesson one day. You know, I said, should I go with my phone or my Bible? And the Spirit tells me they can steal my phone. But have you ever seen a robber stealing your Bible? They will steal your Bible, but you can't steal. They will steal it, they can steal your phone, but you can't steal your Bible. You know? If you carry your phone and your Bible in your hand, you know, they will go with it for this. But they can't steal this. So please, always come with this. And it really helps us one day in our town, in Nigeria. I was going to a very popular bus stop. I won't mention it. And the Spirit of God said, carry your Bible out of, bring your Bible out of that bag. I was carrying a bag. And what happened? I had a sense that I'm going to meet some criminals. That place, very popular place. And say, bring out your Bible. And you know that as soon as I got down, and the Holy Spirit said, look at that guy. And the guy was facing me. And I carried my Bible and I look at his face. And it's as if he was actually targeting me. But by the reason of this in my hand, he couldn't. God has already prepared me ahead. This Bible, God has a way of using it to protect his own people. So please don't feel shy to carry your Bible. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So open to 62 verse 11. Psalm 62 verse 11. God has spoken once, twice I have heard this, that power belongs to God. Amen. All power belongs to God in heaven and in the heart. All power belongs to God. All power belongs to God in heaven and on the earth. All power belongs to God. We give him the glory. His power is amazingly omni. All power belongs to him. Matthew 19:26. But Jesus looked at them and said to them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. Why? Because God has all the power for everything. Amen. There are a lot of things we don't have power to do, but not God. Not God. He has power to do all things. He has the power. Praise the Lord. Christ was leaving planet Earth, going back to the throne in heaven. He said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given unto me. Amen. All. Not small, omni. That's why it's called omnipotent God. Praise the Lord. You see, A.W. Tozer said something and I quoted. He said, God is looking for people through whom he can do the impossible. What a pity that we plan only the things we can do by ourselves. You know, when we want to plan something, we like to plan for things we can handle. But God is looking for somebody who can plan for something he cannot handle. Then you call him God into it. Amen. Christian life is a life that you need to rely on God for the impossible. Why? Because all power belongs to him. There is nothing that is impossible before him. Praise the Lord. We are talking about the amazing God. Everything about God is amazing. What about his grace? His grace is amazingly sufficient. Amen. His grace is amazingly sufficient. Do you know that? Look, you can't, I don't know of any religious leader or any religion that their leader will say, look, my grace is sufficient for you. I don't see any leader or any, religion leader that says, look, I am the all-powerful. No, it's only our God. His grace is amazingly sufficient. He told Peter, he said, look, Peter was praying, Paul was praying, God, remove this stone out of me, remove it from me. The Bible says he prayed to God 3 times and God told him, said, look, leave it there for him. Say, my grace is sufficient for you. Amen. Praise the Lord. I speak that grace into your life. In this season of amazing testimony, the grace of God will be so sufficient for you. As you go, as you come in, you enjoy the grace of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, since it is sufficient, you will not lack the grace of God. That is why faith and grace, we are so blessed that grace is what we enjoy in this ministry. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, my grace is sufficient for you. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. Open your Bible. My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Are you weak in a particular area? What area are you, experiences of weakness? Why not just look unto God for grace? That is why he asks us, he said, we should, you know, come before the throne of grace, that you may obtain mercy and find grace for help in the time of need. The grace of God is available for every situation of our life. Amazing grace. Amazingly sufficient for us. Praise the Lord. And you know, read 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 10. It says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace towards me was not in vain. We are what we are by the grace of God. Thank God for the grace. Everybody say, thank God for the grace of God. For the by this grace also we have been saved through faith. It is a gift of God. It's amazing. Everything about God is amazing. When he wants to manifest a character in his nature, it's always amazing. He uses his grace to save us. He said, look, this thing I'm giving you is sufficient for you. Amen.
Amen.
What about his name? His name is amazing. The name of God is amazing. Everything about God is amazing. You know, that name, the name of God is amazingly great. To the point that the Bible says the name of the Lord is a what? A strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. Amen. Can you imagine? Just the name. Just call on the name and run into it. When you call on the name of the Lord, you are secured. See the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. A name that is above every other name. I speak that every other name that is troubling your life begin to fade away.
Amen.
At the mention of the name of Jesus, every other name must bow.
Amen.
They must bow in the mighty name of Jesus. That is amazing name. Praise the Lord. What about the glory of God? This glory is amazingly transcending. Amen. When we say something is transcending, that this is far above, far beyond whatever you can think of. You know, the glory of God it transcends everything. It's far above everything and far beyond everything. The glory of God is amazingly transcending. Praise the Lord. John 11:40. You remember the story of Lazarus. You know, Lazarus was 4 days already in the grave. 4 days already in the grave. But Jesus got there. He said, remove the stone. And Martha said, by now, there will be a stench in this place. Jesus Christ said something. He said, what? He said, have I not told you, didn't I not say to you, that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? You know, it gives me an understanding of the glory of God. When I say it transcends everything. Is this stench? It's transcended. It's higher, far above it. He said, so immediately they removed the stone. Now what happened? And he called the name of Lazarus to come out. And what happened? Lazarus came out. Why? Because the glorious God spoke. And what happened? Because the one who made the heaven and the earth was standing with his glory. And Lazarus came out, his hands and his mind bound. And what happened? We did not hear of the stench of the game. No record of stench. All we saw was glory. Amen. Everybody say glory. Everybody say glory. So the glory covered the stench. Every stench of your life, every reproach of your life, every shame of your life, the God of glory will cover with his glory today in the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe, you will see that glory. Amen. Praise the Lord. What about the plans of God? His plans are amazingly different. They are amazingly better than our own. The plans of God, they are amazingly different. They are better. If you have a plan, you better surrender it to the plan of God. And make sure you are aligning with the plan of God, because your plan can never be better than the plan of God. See what God was speaking through Jeremiah in Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. He said, for I know the thought I have towards you. Jeremiah was writing to the children of Israel in Babylon in captivity. And yet God says, I know the thought I have towards you. To them, how can somebody be in captivity? And you are telling them you are going to be in this place for 70 years. And God said, yes, I am the one. I know the thought I have towards you. It may sound, and some other prophets were saying, look, within 2 years, I see God bringing you back in 2 years. Jeremiah said, if it is less than 70 years, then I'm not sent by God. And he wrote this, said, for I know the thought, God said, I know the thought I have towards you. I know the plans I have towards you. He said, says the Lord, they are plans for good and not for disaster. To give you a future and a hope. That is the plan of God for you. Whatever you are going through now may look very funny. But if you are connected with this amazing God who carries amazing glory, who has an amazing plan for your life, you can never miss it. You are very sure that the end of the matter is going to be better than the beginning. Because of what? God is planning a future and a hope for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I say the plan of God is better than our plans. Amen. What about his thoughts? His thoughts are far higher. It's amazing that when we have a thought, and by the time God brings us his own thoughts for us, do you know that It's amazing the way the whole thing works out. You know, the Bible says in Isaiah 55 verses 8 to 9. Open your Bible, Isaiah 55 verses 8 to 9. It says, my thoughts are not like your thoughts, says the Lord. And my ways are far beyond anything you could imagine. He said, for just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. His thoughts are far, far, far higher than our thoughts. Amazing thoughts. Amazing God we are talking about. Amen. What about his miracles? Amazing. His miracles, they are simply amazing. There is no miracle performed by our Lord Jesus Christ, or there is no miracle in the Bible that the people are not amazed. Let's go to the Old Bible, Old Testament. Was it the crossing of the Red Sea? Can you imagine? Can you imagine the kind of amazement that would have, you know, come upon the children of Israel? Where they were faced with the Red Sea at the front, and what the children of the Egyptians at the back, they were at the middle, confused. See how God turned their confusion to amazement. Suddenly, they saw an expressway open up on the Red Sea for them. That is how God is going to surprise you. When you get to the end of the road and you don't know where to go from here, when you don't know what to do from this point, God, who made that a highway, an express road on the rest for the children of Israel, we open a door for you where you do not imagine, in the mighty name of Jesus. It's going to be an amazing one, and you are going to have an amazing testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. I say it's going to lead to an amazing testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. There is no miracle of our Lord Jesus Christ or the miracle in the Bible that did not bring about an amazing amazement in the people. When they look at in the book of Luke chapter 9 verse 43, Jesus Christ performed this miracle, and all his miracles are simply amazing, and they were all amazed at the majesty of God. Luke chapter 9 verse 43. Luke chapter 5 verse 26 says, and they were all amazed and they glorified God and were filled with fear, saying, we have seen strange things today. That is amazing God at work. This God is still at work in our life. This is the God we are serving. He's an amazing God. And is going to perform this miracle in our life that will be able to stand and give an amazing testimony. When you share your testimony, people will be amazed.
Amen.
I say, when you share your testimony, people will be amazed.
Amen.
Why? Because it is God, the amazing God, that has made it happen. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
His judgment too, they are amazing. Because it's a God of judgment too. This amazing God is also a God of judgment. One thing about his judgment is they are amazingly just. God cannot judge and somebody will say this God is not fair. God is always just. God is always fair. Amen. Psalm 9 verse 8. Psalm 9 verse 8. Open your Bible. And he judges the world with righteousness. He judges the people with uprightness. That is our God. Amazing God. Amazing judge. You know, when God was judging Nebuchadnezzar, it was amazing. And nobody said, oh, God is not fair. How can you turn a whole king to become an animal? Everybody said, well, he deserves it. He's our just judge. Amen. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 14. He said, for God will bring every deed into judgment with every secret thing, whether good or evil. That is our God for you. God will bring everything into judgment. He's an amazing judge. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. His judgment is amazing. What about his mercy? What is about his mercy? It's amazingly enduring. It endures forever. Can your mercy endure forever? Can you have mercy on somebody? Can you compare your own mercy with the mercy of God? But his own mercy is the one that endures forever. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I know you are giving us time today. It's an anointing day. We still have some extra minute. God bless you. Psalm 136 verse 1 says, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever." You are going to continue to enjoy the mercy of God all the days of your life. Everywhere you go, mercy will speak for you. I say mercy will speak for you. That is why it says, "Come before me on a daily basis. Come before the throne of grace to obtain mercy." So the mercy of God is never exhausted. And the Bible says this mercy, they are new each day. Every day you need a new mercy. So please, I don't want you to take it for granted. Go to him on a daily basis. Don't say, "I went to him yesterday, gave me mercy." I hope he will not be complaining that I'm always coming every day. No. In fact, he will complain if you don't come every day. That's it. That is God. It is we human beings that you will come to us on a daily basis and we complain that leave me alone. But to him, he wants you to come on a daily basis because he has new mercy each day, and you will not miss your mercy in Jesus' name. When the spirit of death comes around, mercy will say no. When sickness comes around, when COVID-19 comes around, mercy will say no to it. In the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 145 verse 8 and 9. Psalm 145, 8 and 9. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and great in mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercy are all over his work. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our God is a merciful God. I'm running up right now so that we can have time to pray. Amen. He said, "Let us therefore come boldly before the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." Amen. Today we are going to tap from the throne of mercy. We are going to receive mercy so that this amazing God will show his mercy upon us. We enjoy the grace of God because it's amazing. It's amazing everything we receive from God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My prayer is that this amazing God will cause an amazing testimony. At least, I pray that every member of this church, at least one amazing testimony you will share on this altar in the mighty name of Jesus. You will share on this altar in the mighty name of Jesus. One of our brethren right there outside the U.S. He was sharing his testimony and saying, "Look, what God has done in his life this year, all the years he has been working, he has never experienced such an amazing thing." Amen. And that will be your testimony. And that is just at the first quarter. He said what he was able to make in the first quarter, all since he had been working, he has never, achieved such a feat. And this is just first quarter. And by the grace of God, by the time he will be finishing second quarter, by the time he will be going third quarter, by the time he will be going, I wonder how the testimony will be. It will be super amazing. You will come with a super amazing. In this season of amazing testimony, you are the next candidate for testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus. Peradventure, you have not given your life to Jesus. It will be very difficult for you to enjoy this amazing God. And if you are ready to do so, why not just say this prayer with me? It's a prayer of faith so that you can join us as we want to pray to this amazing God and get ourselves anointed for another season of amazing testimony. If you are ready to give your life to Jesus, I want you to say this short prayer with me. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sin. Please forgive me. Come into my life. I receive you as my Lord and my Savior. Now help me to live for you the rest of my life. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. If you have said this prayer of faith, your names are written in the book of life. And I want to pray with you. Father, I pray for everyone that have declared that have said this prayer, oh Lord, that you will receive them, oh Lord Almighty. And Lord Almighty, write their name in the book of life. Lord Almighty and Lord, cause them, oh Lord, to continue to grow in this grace in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have said this prayer, you need to join yourself to a Bible-believing church. Around you, wherever you are, make sure you join yourself to a Bible-believing church where there you continue to grow in the Lord. Amen. And if you are around Eastern in Bishop area, join yourself with Faith and Grace Church. We are here that by the grace of God will be discipled and continue to grow in this grace. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.